Hi, this is Aditya from Light Haven. Today we're going to continue from where we left off in our last video when we were talking about medium range thrusting and slashing. So if you haven't seen our last video, I'm going to leave a link in the description below. So first have a look at that one, get comfortable with the drills shown there, and then come and try this one out. So in the last video we introduced the concept of every thrust is followed by a slash and every slash is followed by a thrust. The way we done it, we started from our shoulder load, slash down in front of our opposite hip, thrust back to cross load, slash down in front of our opposite hip, thrust back to shoulder load. Now, these are rather big movements and they're fine to introduce the concept of thrusting and slashing to you, but they're not very effective. In this drill, we're going to tighten up that movement, and instead of starting with a slash, we're going to start with our thrust. So we start from sort of in line with our right hip, if the weapon is in your right hand. And we're going to first start with a thrust, which is going to be followed by a slash, thrust, slash, thrust and slash, thrust and slash. The thrust is sort of up, curved upwards, thrust up, slash down. When I slash now, I'm coming in front of my opposite hip or just outside of my opposite hip with the tip of my weapon facing my opponent. From here, I'm going to thrust, slash, thrust, slash, thrust, slash. So thrust and slash, thrust and slash. It's up to you the target that you want to choose, whether you want to choose the low thrust and slash, medium thrust and slash, or higher up thrust and slash. I want you to be able to thrust all the way up until it's in front, until the tip of the blade is in front of your nose, and then slash back down until the punyo is in front of your opposite hip or just outside the opposite hip, and then again thrust until the tip is in front of your nose, slash down either in front of your hip or just outside of the hip, thrust up, slash, thrust and slash, thrust and slash, thrust and slash. Now the slashes are also very small, we don't have big fluid cuts over here. The small slashes. One thing to sort of stay, be careful about, and a mistake that oftentimes people make. The shape that we're trying to make over here is this closed triangle, right? The tip of that closed triangle is in front of your nose. That's why you're thrusting up your nose and slashing down to the opposite hip. Oftentimes people will make that triangle sort of horizontally. So it'll go thrust and slash, almost horizontal. There's nothing necessarily wrong with that, but learning the movement as sort of this vertical or diagonal-ish triangle will make you more versatile later. It means that this has a lot more applications than this sort of horizontal triangle. So in the beginning, that's something to be careful about, that you're not, when you're thrusting and slashing, you're not making this triangle horizontally, you're making it either vertically or diagonally with the tip of the triangle in front of your own nose. So thrust up in front of your own nose, slash down to the opposite hip, thrust up in front of your own nose, slash down in front of your own hip. The last thing we're going to talk about is body mechanics. Now if I just use the muscles in my arm, and I'm a rather small guy, if I use just the muscles in my arm to try and thrust and slash this, there's not going to be so much penetration or power within this. I need to drive from my entire body into the tip of that sword. One of the ways that I like to think about it is I'm going for that either that body uppercut or that body hook. The same sort of drive from the hip and the connection to the hand is what you're looking for. That same sort of movement. So when I'm here, it's that same, it's driving from the hip, you're pushing off the ground and driving from the hip. Driving from the hip and sinking into, so I'm driving from the hip for the thrust, sinking into the slash. Driving from the hip into the thrust, sinking into the slash. Thrust, slash, thrust, slash. It's going to take a while for that to settle into your body, so go slow. And let your hips move. Let them be mobile. Right? And then you can add your footwork into this. So you can do your ranging footwork. Thrust and slash, thrust and slash. You can do your open triangle footwork, your closed triangle footwork, whatever type of footwork you want, you can add that into it. As long as you're making sure that the triangle is this way and not horizontal, and you're trying to link your hips and your feet and your whole body with your weapon, and driving through with the whole body into the weapon. Guys, as usual, thank you for watching Monsoons Come to Goa. I'm doing this in the rain. If you liked what you saw, if you learned from what you saw, please do like, subscribe and share. It really does help out the school a lot. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.